member from Red Deer South.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and congratulations on your recent election. I've really enjoyed listening to the maiden speeches of some of my colleagues, and it's helped me gain a greater appreciation of both of them as individuals and the great areas in which they serve. I'm thankful for the opportunity to share my meeting speech.
Just to clarify, this is not going under 29.2A. This is a maiden speech.
I'm grateful for the opportunity to share my maiden speech as a response to our throne speech. An overarching theme of our throne speech was a message of renewal and hope. With that message in mind, and as a response to our throne speech, I will share my hope for our province, for my constituency, Red Deer South, and last of all, for the honourable members of this Legislative Assembly. First, my hope for Alberta. Mr. Speaker, we are living in interesting times. Governments are failing us. The out-of-control spending ways of our governments have done a great disservice to our children. The old ways are not sustainable ways. The old ways are this: ineffective, inefficient governments with uncompetitive taxes and unsustainable billion-dollar debts and deficits. So what has been the result? Mr. Speaker, in the past 4 years leading up to our election, Alberta's debt has increased by over $45 billion. Mr. Speaker, cumulative $45 billion deficits are easy for irresponsible governments to incur. These gigantic debts are much, much harder for Albertans to pay for or even to comprehend. To put $45 billion into perspective, the prior government's deficits are massive enough to buy every single home in Red Deer, Alberta's third largest city, mortgage-free, not once, but twice. An undisciplined government did that in only 4 years. Mr. Speaker, these debts will be a burden for our children and the rising generation. This truth cannot be ignored. Spending money you do not have is not the definition of successful government. Governments are supposed to be our allies in protecting our freedom and prosperity. They are not supposed to be impediments to freedom and prosperity. In these challenging times, our governments need to be much, much better. Mr. Speaker, on April 16th, Albertans took a big, positive step in the right direction to bring back Alberta's economic prosperity for ourselves and opportunities for our children by electing this new government. This government's legislative program, as articulated in the throne speech, includes the following two priorities: renewing Alberta's economic prosperity and placing the public interest at the heart of sustainable government. Mr. Speaker, there is an interrelationship between these two priorities. Without a strong economy, there are no taxes from private sector businesses and those who work in them. And when there are no taxes from the private sector, there is no money to pay for government. Mr. Speaker, the facts speak for themselves. Alberta is better off with governments who live within their means, know how to compete and attract investment in the real world, and support economic growth and individual choices. That is how Alberta has competed and excelled. As set out in the throne speech, this legislature will renew and restore Alberta as the most competitive and attractive jurisdiction in Canada to start and grow a business. And that is a very good start. However, there is more for government to do. There is a required culture change in government. Our premier has expressed Alberta's culture as follows. Alberta is a meritocracy, open to the talents of all, a place where we assess people not on the basis of where they were born, how they pray, or who they love, but on how hard they work and how well they treat others. That is the culture of Alberta in the real world. That is not always the culture of Alberta in the government world. Often, a government culture is not meritocracy. Sometimes it is mediocrity. Mr. Speaker, why is there a disconnect between Alberta's real-world culture of meritocracy and government's common culture of mediocrity? Mr. Speaker, the difference is accountability. Without accountability, there can be no meritocracy. Some in government shun accountability, but in the real world, we are all accountable to our families, to our friends, to clients and customers, and our own personal morality. And all of these stewardships motivate us to work hard, to be honest, and strive to do better. Striving to do better is our aim in the real world, and that is what we need in the government world. In these challenging times, we can afford nothing less. We need a government culture which strives for excellence, sets a good example for our children, lives within its means, is accountable, and focuses on serving the public interest in an efficient and effective manner. Mr. Speaker, government plays a vital role in our society, but there is a growing contempt and distrust of the rising generations in unsustainable and effective government institutions. A deep culture change to meritocracy and accountability in government is the antidote. Mr. Speaker, better days are ahead for Alberta. Now, Mr. Speaker, I would like to share my hope for Red Deer. Red Deer is a blessed place. It is a place of great potential. Red Deer is an attractive city. Its population is about 100,000. It is not too big. It is not too small. It is centrally located between Calgary and Edmonton. We have a river. We have great parks and amenities and lakes and other recreational opportunities close by. We will have our own university. Red Deer is a home of great entrepreneurs, businesses, individuals, and families. Red Deer is the home of many great servant leaders who I have had the privilege to get to know better in this important capacity. I grew up here. I chose to start a business here, and my wife and I chose to raise our three children here. Mr. Speaker, like all communities, Red Deer has unique strengths and needs. I have discussed some of its strengths. I will now outline one of its needs. The Red Deer Regional Hospital serves Red Deer, plus its surrounding rural communities, comprising up to hundreds of thousands of Albertans. The Red Deer Regional Hospital had development plans over the years and had been listed as a priority project prior to 2016. But in the fall of 2016, it was dropped off the infrastructure funding list by the prior government with little or no explanation as to why. This hospital has been under-supported by government with a gross disparity in per capita funding over the past 10 years, which has left Central Alberta with a deficit of up to 10 times the rest of the province for hospital infrastructure. As a specific example, Red Deer has no cardiac cath lab. This is a time-sensitive, life-or-death health service. As a result of no cath lab to treat heart attacks and related issues, Central Albertans have a higher death and disability rate from these issues than people in other areas of the province. Mr. Speaker, though, Red Deer does not need, nor does it seek, special treatment. Red Deer can succeed and prosper on its own merits, as it always has. However, similar to Alberta's requests from Canada, Red Deer only requests equitable treatment from a principled government. Mr. Speaker, as set out in the throne speech, this new government will be principled. Mr. Speaker, better days are ahead for Red Deer. Last of all, Mr. Speaker, I want to close by expressing my hope for this 30th Legislative Assembly. In these challenging times, we need the best, most qualified individuals possible in government who are willing to sacrifice, serve, and do their best. To be successful, this government will need to make significant course corrections, and that is going to require individuals with the determination to do what is right. Mr. Speaker, I was entrusted with the United Conservative Party nomination for Red Deer on March 16th. Exactly 1 month later, on April 16th, I was elected as MLA for Red Deer South. It was very hard work, and it demanded personal sacrifice. However, the importance of this election deserved nothing less than our own very best effort. I am surrounded by colleagues who did nothing less, who worked hard and sacrificed and succeeded in the crucible of nomination events and elections with other excellent contestants and candidates. The overall caliber of this government caucus is likely the strongest that Alberta has ever seen. I respect all of the members who are here with me, including those on the opposite side. Each of them has strengths, and it takes courage and grit to run and succeed. Mr. Speaker, last week I attended my first question period. I was disappointed to observe a few members consistently yelling and interrupting as ministers stood to answer questions. That was rude. Mr. Speaker, all of the members of this assembly are capable and talented adults and are better than that. My hope is that we can choose to act with more civility, to set a better example for our children, and counter the growing contempt in government institutions. Mr. Speaker, notwithstanding our individual differences, all of us share a common desire for freedom to seek happiness as we individually see fit. With that common interest in mind, we can choose to strive to act respectfully and with civility one with another. In closing, at the end of the day, what we take with us in this life is our character and our relationships. As a member of this assembly, my desire is to serve to the best of my ability all Albertans and every resident in Red Deer South. This can be our shared hope, with the limited time given to each of us, to give our best and contribute what we can for the public interest and make Alberta better for our children and the rising generations. And then, having done so, step back and allow others the same opportunity. Thank you.